I'm just gonna make sure that we're live, that we're live streaming, and we are. Cool. We're on Twitch. Good morning for those of you, I guess, on the west coast of Canada. Hey, Chichoy Index, how are you doing? That's cool. That's the quickest anybody's ever come on here, I think. Long time no see, actually. I haven't seen you on a stream for a while. And just, hey, Chicho, how you doing? Doing good, brother. Doing good, brother. Been looking forward to this stream, actually. Just because politics has been coming up in almost every stream. A lot of streams we've been doing. So I think it's time to dedicate a stream on a regular basis to talk about politics. That way politics is not going to seep into the other stuff that we're going to do, and this is going to be sort of a venue for people to discuss politics if they want to discuss politics. Okay, and those of you, I'm not sure if we're going to end up loading this on Twitch, on YouTube. It'll definitely be loaded on BitChute, but depending on the topic of conversation and how deep we go and how I control myself in trying to stay as neutral as possible to a certain degree, we might load it on YouTube, we might not. But for those of you watching on another platform after the live stream is done, just so you know, I'll provide links in the description of this video for anything that we reference or some of the things that we will reference, and I'll provide a table of contents at least pointing you to when, because I'm going to do a little intro before we start the discussion, and we're going to wait about 5-10 minutes for people to come into the stream, because this is a live stream that we're doing. But I will provide sort of a timestamp in the description of this video for those of you that want to look into this, you know, skip the sort of the meet and greet that we do in every stream and go to the introduction. And if the topics in the open discussion for politics, economics, sort of organize themselves in a coherent manner, I'll provide a link to the timestamps for the table of contents is in the description as well. But most likely, it's just going to be when the intro happens, and then we're just going to dive into the open discussion. Ready for this to get heated? Yeah, maybe. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows where we'll go with this, right? So we'll give people, you know, 10 minutes or so to come in to sort of decide. I sort of sent out a little thing on Twitter saying that we're live, and I'm assuming when I set up an event on Twitch, it does send out a little notice to people that we are live. Okay, and we'll see where this goes. There's a lot happening in the world. A lot of things we have to be aware of. So I think it's long overdue that we got into this. We got back into the topic of discussion. Okay. And we'll just leave it there. And I have a couple of things that I want to... A couple of things I wrote in previous articles when I was blogging about politics. A couple of things I want to read to you guys just to set the tone, just to let you know where I'm coming from. And what my mindset is. And then, you know, we'll take it to wherever it goes from there, whatever people want to talk about. And if we can find any data to back up any claims, we'll look for it. If there is, you know, we can't find data, and sometimes it's hard to find data. Sometimes it's anecdotal. Sometimes it's just experience, right? That's what we have to go with. So, you know, we'll work on that and see where that takes us. Okay. Aside from that, welcome to a stream, welcome to a live stream, and we'll see how it goes. This might be a short stream, might be less than an hour, might be 2 hours or longer. Again, depending how heated the discussion gets and where we end up going. There's a lot of political debates going on right now. And the world sort of splitting up, going in different directions, not just two, multiple directions, depending on where you are. And, you know, there's certain things to watch out for that are coming up. some major things to watch out for that are coming up, specifically related to economics. Some of the stuff we've talked about already regarding disruptive innovation and differential accumulation, and mergers and acquisitions, and all that jazz. Apologies about the camera if it's getting blurry or not sharp. At some point, I'll look into grabbing higher quality cameras. These are HD, the webcams, they are HD 1080, but they have a hard time focusing sometimes. They zoom in and out, so I guess I'm supposed to be standing still, not doing any depth changes on these things. Okay, so we're about 6 minutes in. Should we do a little intro? Let's do a little intro. Okay. As far as the introduction goes to this political discussion, let me read you a couple of things that I wrote in previous articles. There's sometimes I kept on repeating myself in different articles. I took little paragraphs or sentences here that I had and that I posted on a certain article and reused it again. So let me read you this one little part that I have, and I use this part in two different articles. Okay, let me give you the link for the articles if you wanna know where these are. This is the one that I'm reading right now. Okay, the title of this article is, and I wrote this article in 2013. Okay, the title of this article is the title of this article is 1, 2, 3, 4. When are we going to go to war? 5, 6, 7, 8. Are you out of your fucking mind? What we should know before waging war on Syria. Okay, and I wrote this in 2013 because the war machine, the are you a postmodern neo-Marxist? I don't think so. I don't know what postmodern neo-Marxist means. There's so much implied to words, right? To descriptions, right? But I'll read you this part. I think this was the beginning of the article. Let me make sure. Yeah, this was at the first three paragraphs of the article. Okay, so here's the first three paragraphs of that article, and I used the same thing in this article as well. Okay, let me post you this article as well. Doop. And when I was writing these things, sometimes some of these were transferred over from my previous blog, so I might have written these a little bit earlier, but I think the one we're going to read, and the title for the second link that I sent you, the article, the title is, "It's not the economy, stupid. It's your stupid foreign policy. How to get rid of all our oligarchs," right? And that piece had five different subheadings where I posted information. One of them was 1953 regime change in Iran. Okay, so 1953 regime change in Iran. Part two was war crimes in Iraq. Part three was mainstream media and the need for insurrection. Part four was Gladio B and the grand chessboard. And part five was the need to become politically aware. And what I'm going to read you is appears in part five of the second link that I sent you, and appears at the beginning of the first link that I sent you. Oh, hello. How are you? I'm doing good, Sorox. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're doing well. If it's morning, afternoon, or evening for you, wherever you might be in the world, right? So here's my little intro. The thing that appears in both articles. Everything is politics, from what we eat to what we drink, from what society deems acceptable behavior to what it considers a criminal offense, from who we interact with to how we interact with them. Politics decides if we are free or if we live as slaves in bondage. Politics determines what our children are taught in school, how we treat the ecosystem, what theories scientists investigate, how art is perceived, what version of history we recall, and how the future will remember us. In essence, politics governs our thoughts, our understanding of reality, and how we and our society evolve. It is therefore essential that we participate in the political process. It may be through demonstrations, whistleblowing, elections, activism, disobedience, or a myriad of other forms of direct action, or may it be through simple analysis so that we have a full understanding of what is being done in our name. Okay, and that sort of brings us to here, right? How art is perceived. Ooh, sounds like postmodernism to me. Why does art have to be political? Art doesn't have to be political. Politics forces its views on art. Just look at comic book censorship, right? In the golden age of comics. During the golden age of comics in the 1950s, people freaked out because comic books, and you have to keep in mind, comic books at the time in the 1950s, they were for everyone. There was no one, very few people had TV in their houses, right? There was no internet. There was print media, print news, and comic books were a form of entertainment or a form of education, right? And entertainment has multiple branches to it. Maybe adult entertainment, children's, educational entertainment, or whatever it might be. But politics forced itself onto comic books, and it censored comic books for a number of decades, right? Number of decades, right? We've talked about this. So art doesn't have to be political. The problem is politics, governments, institutions, extremists on all sides around the globe force their opinions on everything, including art. Okay, do you ascribe to the idea that art is autonomous and in some way separate from its social context? No, I don't think so. It could be, I think it could be, but I don't think it necessarily is. Okay, now just gonna, how are you? I'm doing good, Vanta. Yo, bro, yo, 39012512, how are you doing? Okay, I'm gonna read the second part of this intro. Okay, so that was sort of the main theme, why I was getting into politics, when I started writing about politics in 2005, 2006, and I was talking about politics. I've been talking about politics forever, right? But let me post another link of a, basically, the last two links, the first one I wrote in 2013, the second one I sent you, I wrote in 2014, I believe. It might have been earlier, okay? Now this last link I'm gonna send you, I wrote in 2014. Glad to catch you, lad. Glad to have you here, brother or sister. Okay, here's the third link from one of the posts that I did when I was writing politics pretty heavy, right? And I wrote this one in 2014, and this was basically the final strictly geopolitical post I planned on doing on my site, because I kept on repeating myself, right? Yes and no. Because I kept on repeating myself, I was getting tired of regurgitating the same thing and being appalled by what was going on politically, okay, geopolitically specifically, right? Locally as well, but geopolitically. But let me read you just two sections. I want to read you the beginning part of this last article that I wrote, and I called it Synopsis of Our Present Predicament, What the Future Holds, a Final Word. Okay, and this was sort of me wrapping up politics on my blog, and that was written 2014. Okay, the intro to this was this. In the last few years, the information presented on this site and the previous site have provided my perspective on our present predicament regarding geopolitics specifically what we are in the midst of and what the future may hold. And a lot of the, I provided a lot of references, a lot of links to a lot of other information, maybe data or previous articles that I wrote that reference other information, right? When I say what the future holds, I wrote a huge piece regarding Africa. And I basically, in that post, I said, the future of Africa looks bleak, and here's why. And it was a 3-4-parter, I believe. And it took a few months to do it. I did it in parts, right? The second part of that paragraph is this. In short, the main problem with our society is that our education system is designed to instill obedience, and it has done so extremely well. We have willingly consumed propaganda to the point where our hypnosis has turned us into servants of totalitarian regimes. That's the intro to that. And I provide a whole bunch of other information, links, and, you know, quotes and stuff in the body of that post. Okay, just to summarize everything that we've talked about as best as I could. There was a lot we talked about in like 8 years or something, talking about politics. Okay, but towards the end, the conclusion, the last couple of paragraphs of that piece, this is what I wrote. When I think of all this and more, which is everything that I referenced before, the only fathomable excuse that comes to mind as to why we have forfeited so much, the only words that bring me comfort regarding our collective insensibility come from George Carlin, pointing out that the cause of our ills is because half of humanity is dumber than the average person. Okay, and I write down George Carlin's quote here, and I provide a video, and there's a lot of videos embedded within that article. I provide a little video of George Carlin stating this, right? And this is the quote from George Carlin. Quote, think of how stupid the average person is and realize half of them are stupider than that, end quote. And that's George Carlin, right? And then I finished that article with the following three paragraphs. Why George Carlin's words bring me comfort is because they imply that the problem has a solution, education. Hence my work on mathematics. The alternative, that we are aware of our history and we are indifferent to it, is unthinkable. Okay. Since I have no desire to document the play-by-play symphony of carnage that is being unleashed and is to come, and since I have said what needed to be said, or as Arundhati Roy would say, I feel that I don't have anything direct to say without repeating myself. That's quoting Arundhati Roy. I should have said that. Quoting Arundhati Roy, quote, I feel that I don't have anything direct to say without repeating myself, end quote. We'll consider this post to be the introduction to politics on Chicho, and it will be the last strictly geopolitical discussion we have on this site for quite some time, at least until Russia, China, Iran, or another formidable enemy of our choosing or making is duped into directly confronting NATO, or until the next major false flag operation sends the world into a frenzy. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to send me a message or post a comment. You can find additional information in the politics and economics section of the table of contents. Some of the more popular posts can be found in the right-hand column of this site. Okay. That was my intro to our politics. I might make a recorded video HD camera with a lapel mic and stuff if we're going to continue to do this on a regular basis. And then probably if it happens, we'll create our own playlist on YouTube and BitChute. I'm not creating a playlist on BitChute yet, but I will at some point. But we'll create a playlist to have all these political discussions. And once we do that, I'll create a little intro video for that, just going over that again, just to let people know where I am. Okay, I just wanted to give that intro for this first official political discussion we're having. Okay, just to let you know where I'm coming from. And that final post I wrote in 2014, when it was obvious where we were headed, right? Because what I try to do in regards to politics, I try to stay on top of politics and economics, and I basically have a 5-year plan, 5 to 10-year plan. I sort of plan out what I believe is going to happen geopolitically and economically for the next 5 to 10 years, and I adjust my behavior accordingly, my investments and whatnot, right? The way I conduct business, okay? And I have a long-term view as well, okay? Just let you know where I'm coming from. I'm just going to read some more comments. Yes and no. Some art transcends the period it was created and endures. 100%. A lot of art, moments of brilliance, okay, is a way ahead of its time. Way ahead of its time. Bill Hicks is one example, right? Many, you know, and it's science as well. Science as well, right? A lot of scientists throughout history that have come up with new ideas, the establishment has shunned them and in some cases forced them to commit suicide, right? So a lot of information that is going to see us into the future is suppressed by those in power because they don't want to lose power, because a lot of information that comes up challenges the status quo. There's a saying in science where we say science doesn't progress one idea at a time, science progresses one death at a time, right? Our understanding of the world progresses one death at a time, because those who have been in power maintain power, and if there's anything new that comes up in general that challenges their beliefs, right, they suppress that information or they eliminate the people presenting that information. Okay, it works with music, it works with paintings, drawings, poetry, art, right? Every form of art. Okay, indeed it does. But reception history modifies its meaning in every era. What kind of classical music? Classical, normalism, modernism. Yeah, there's so much. Is religion necessary for developing a country? I don't think so. I don't believe so. No. A country has certain implications. The word country has certain meaning, I guess. I would say, because country is a new, I believe it's a new concept anyway, right? There are, you know, last few hundred years where we've thought about countries. Previously to that, we were thinking about empires and tribes and whatever it might be, right? So I'm not sure if country is the right word to use. I would say my take would be, is religion necessary for the development of a tribe? I would say no. I believe there has to be teachers, there has to be people who push the boundaries of being, of thought, exploring, may it be on the physical realm or the spiritual realm, consciousness or whatever it might be. For small tribes, historically we would go to shamans, right? Is shamanism a religion? I don't, you know, what does the word religion mean, right? Is religion institutional religion, or is it spirituality, or is it in the belief system that this matter that we see is not everything that we know, there's something beyond this, right? And that goes in the realm of science as well, right? 95% of the mass of the universe is not accounted for. We can't interact with it, we can't measure it, we don't know what it is, right? If as a scientist we know that as a fact, right, the data presents that information, the models that we have tell us that there's 90% of something in the universe that we don't know what it is, right? The mathematics, the physics comes out, we just don't know how to measure it or interact with it, right? So as a scientist, if you just assume that everything there is whatever you see, then you're not a scientist, you're You can call it whatever you want to call it. Okay, you're delusional. Right? Because everything we see is not it, right? Our eyes only see a small spectrum of light. Light spectrum is huge. We only see a fraction of it, right? So there's a lot beyond what we see, what we can interact with at the moment, right? Happy to be a kid again. Day, Chicho, and National Ice Cream Day Sunday. Oh, it is Sunday. I got ice cream in the freezer. I should go get some ice cream. Start eating some ice cream. That's okay. We'll skip the ice cream. Okay. So open discussion, gang. Now that I've given you guys my intro, where I'm coming from, we can talk about anything you guys want to talk about. I'll try to answer you as best as I can. Okay. And if there isn't, we'll leave it alone. We'll make sure we'll come back and do more political discussions. I should have brought a graphic novel, something that I'm reading right now, Epic of Gilgamesh here. Just to mention, I'm really enjoying it. And a lot of religion, just the topic of religion, Neo-Nib, is religion necessary for developing country? What I'm reading right now, and the oldest known long work, piece of written text, okay, body of work, not just word, not just sentences or poetry or something like this, but an epic, the longest known epic that we know of, that has been written by humanity so far that we know as a general public. We don't, you know, if there's anything out there that we're not, you know, hasn't been let out into the mainstream, that we're not privy to, any type of information that we're not privy to, we don't know, right? My personal belief, and many people's personal belief, and the facts say that humanity is on, you know, we have been on Earth building structures and interacting with the world, knowing mathematics and how the cosmos, you know, where we are in the cosmos, right, where we are in the universe, for tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of years, right? That's how long humanity's been in. But Epic of Gilgamesh is a few thousand years ago. It's the longest body of text, a story that we know of, right? And that text is the basis of most religions in the world, right? Mythology. So it's must read for anyone that has any questions regarding religion, mythology, humanity, countries, civilization, and all that jazz, right? It's important to remember that historically philosophy and theology were interconnected. Before Luther, religion and philosophy were effectively inseparable. And science as well. I would include sciences there as well. Mathematics, science. My first live stream. Hello, Starkey. You got a live one. Like, literally, this is politics. This is our first main politics, officially open discussion of politics, because it's been coming up a lot. Do you think we would be more advanced today if we wouldn't have gone through the Dark Ages? 100%, 100%. And we're actually just coming out of the Dark Ages now again. Just think about this for a second. There's been a war on consciousness globally for a number of decades, right? Certain shamanistic practices that have been with humanity for tens of thousands of years were criminalized, were made illegal just in the last 100 years, right? All of a sudden there was a huge war on drugs, right? Drugs, we'll call them nature, plants, ethnogens, right? Where anybody that was practicing consuming foods of the earth, foods of the gods, some would say, some have written books about, right? They made that illegal. That meant that exploring your own consciousness, your own being, was made illegal. In many countries right now, there are chemicals that are illegal that will get you thrown in jail for decades that are actually within our bodies, that are in our brains, right? There's a chemical that you have right now in your brain, physically. There's a chemical that you have in your brain that is illegal in most Western countries that'll get you thrown in jail. Just think about that absurdity for a second, right? So I think we would be way ahead where we are globally if we didn't have the Dark Ages and we didn't have the centralization control of human behavior, right? And we're just coming out of that. Nothing's guaranteed that we're gonna come out of it, right? But things are shaking, right? Just because of information, which is one reason why we have to make sure that the internet does not become completely 100% centralized, where a central body can control what is flowing through it, right? I'm reading the Edda. The Edda, the Edda. I don't know the Edda. What is the Edda? The Edda. Is that a... The Edda is an old Norse term that has been attributed by modern scholars to the collective of two medieval Icelandic literary works. Oh, really? Cool. Let's check this out. Literary works. What's the date on this? Icelandic. Medieval Icelandic literary works, what is now known as the Prosoedda, and an older collection of poems without an original title, now known as the Poetic Edda. The term historically referred only to the Prose Edda, but this since has fallen out of da, 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 da. Both works were written down in Iceland during the 13th century in Icelandic. Cool. I wonder what that stuff talks about. That's interesting. I didn't know about the Edda. Hey man, how are you? Where is Spencer? I don't know. What's Spencer? Our savior, Donald Trump. How are you doing? I love your name, brother. I love your name. It's true. We may not know some things because of the legal status, because scientists can't study it. Scientists, not only scientists, but human beings. We can't interact with certain things because it's illegal. You can have all your assets forfeited, your family torn apart, and you thrown in jail. Wow. Certain countries you could get executed. Wow. Incredible. Index Chicho, I would agree that the technological mediation of information, algorithmic news, and social media feed back loops is creating a new kind of false consciousness. I agree with you, Index. But I think that's not gonna last long. Right now we're seeing the first wave of it. I think that's gonna it's a 15 minutes of, if you're talking about persons, 15 minutes of fame and they're done. I think this is just something new that's come about, right? Because of, it's novelty. So everyone's jumping on the bandwagon and being appalled by certain things which are irrelevant to them or irrelevant to humanity. They're just sound bites, right? So it's just something new. Just to give you an example, when I was creating videos, when I started creating videos on YouTube back in 2006, 2000, 2006, 2007, I guess 2005, mid 2000s, right? My videos, especially the mathematics ones, right? The math videos, I needed to make them long because I was trying to explain concepts in mathematics, right? And I knew people, that were involved with the internet, with making videos and stuff like this. And they were like, "Chicho, your videos are way too long. You need them to be 2 minutes, no longer than 2.5 minutes, no longer than 5 minutes, average 2.5 minutes each because people, tune out after 2.5 minutes and stuff like this." I was like, "Dude, I can't explain the math concept in 2.5 minutes or 5 minutes. Ideally, I would like it to be an hour, but at the time when I was loading on videos on YouTube had a time limit, right? Only 10 minutes, right? You couldn't make your videos longer than 10 minutes, right? So I would split them up and try to put these things together, right? But at my core, I knew that was just what was happening at the moment because this was novel, right? People going on YouTube checking stuff out. And I knew that was going to fade away and people would want to see longer, more extended videos, thoughts, interactions, right? Because people don't want sound bites. Okay. So what happened last little while, the last couple of years, what Google has done, what YouTube has done, they said view counts are not as important as watch time now, right? So right now, the longer the video, the better to a certain degree, the longer the retention, right? Oh, okay, fine and dandy. So all those people that made 2.5 minute videos, 5 minute videos, you know, just based on the revenue stream and stuff like this, they're not getting as big of a bang, and they're not being, you know, based on Google's, YouTube's algorithm, they're not being queued up and stuff like this. So I think what we're seeing with this herd mentality through social media, it is forming human consciousness. But what's going to happen is a lot of people are being burned by picking a side which they weren't aware of, and they look like idiots, right? So what's happening is they're getting burned, and now they're a little bit more cautious of getting involved with certain types of hall, with certain types of hypes, and being appalled by sound bites and putting their time and energy into something that really doesn't matter or something that they're not really aware of, right? It's happening now. People are being burned by it. I don't know how long this is going to take time to play out, but I think what's going to happen is slowly as people deviate away from corporate news, corporate media, and as technology rolls out more and more, where people are growing up with technology, they're growing up with social media, they're not going to be appalled because they've had the experience. Okay, I think what we're seeing is an anomaly. We're just seeing the first wave of this disruptive innovation making its way into our society. I think that's going to dissipate. There's a lot of damage being done, don't get me wrong. There's a lot of damage being done by this herd mentality where all of a sudden someone's name is popping up in the mainstream corporate news and their lives are being destroyed, right? And all of these social justice warriors being appalled by whatever it is they're being appalled by, right? But I think that's going to die out as people are proven to be just being used as tools. I hope so anyway. I hope so anyway. I'm tremendous. Thanks for asking. Nice. How are you? I'm doing good. Our savior, Donald Trump Index. It's scary how people can create their own reality today. Yeah, I agree, Milestone. Very, very scary. Spamalot, how are you doing? Interesting, good point. You can't make your videos longer than 10 minutes on YouTube unless you verify with a phone. In the past, there was no verification by phone or anything like this. If you remember back in the early 2000s, one of the mantras of Google was never re re never reveal your personal information online, right? That was one of the main things that Google had, right? Don't reveal your personal information. Don't use your real name. Don't use your real contact information, your real address, your real this, your real this, your real this. Right? That was in the early 2000s, mid 2000s, towards the end of 2000s, it changed up, right? Oh, now they wanted your phone number. They wanted your address. They wanted your real name. They wanted this. They wanted that. They wanted that. Right? Complete about turn. Why? Well, that's corporate media, corporate America, corporate reality in the Western world. They require all that information to control the dialogue, the discourse, right? Right now, you may need a phone. Okay, I'm linked up through all that because I've been putting up videos for, I don't know, mid-2000s on YouTube, right? So I don't know what it is right now, Miles. Fake news. Donald Trump. Chicho, not related to politics, but I've been offered Captain America 160 to 227 for 160 pounds. Should I bite? Depends on the shape. I would have to take a look at. I'm not, you know, I know earlier Captain America, some of the stuff, but I don't know the specific issues for Captain America. I would have to take a look at Captain America number 160 to 227. I believe one of the ones there is Captain America against the. I have some of those issues, but I can't remember which ones are important ones or not. It really depends on the shape that they're in. Okay, so really look at the condition they're in and look at the key issues. My recommendation would be make a list, go to there's two websites I use to find prices on things. I say three websites. I use eBay, right? eBay completed listings. If you want to find out, look for Captain America lots and see how much they've been selling for or specific numbers. There's a price guide, comicbookpriceguide.com. I go in there and I go, you know, list all the runs sequentially. So you can go Captain America and then hit the Captain America series. This is the second series, I guess, right? And look at the numbers, see if there's any key issues. You'll know the key issues because they'll be more expensive. Make sure those are available in the lot that you have and check out the prices that way, what the mint condition and what the condition that you're buying them in. And go to mycomicshop.com. I don't buy any comics from mycomicshop.com, but they have a great database, really fantastic database. And you can buy comics there. And there are some comic books which are cheap to buy there. I would, if I was in the States, most likely some comics I would grab, right? So check that as well. Do use those three sources to price things out for yourself and see if 160 pounds is a good deal, right? That's what I would do. And that's what I do with a lot of lots that I do buy. Okay. You should watch the episode of the show Star Trek where Neil Tice, oh, Star Talk, Star Trek, Neil, Star Talk, where Neil Tyson interviewed Katie Couric and he had a discussion about news in the information age. You know what, Miles, I don't like Neil deGrasse Tyson, the person who took over Cosmos, I believe. If that's a person, I'm not going to say anything else until we confirm that's the person we're talking about. Neil deGrasse Tyson, I'm assuming that's the person we're talking about, right? If that's the person we're talking about, I don't like him. He's control. He's a control mechanism. I've heard him say stuff which is absurd, absurd. You know, he talks as if he talks about science in words as if we know everything. So anything that contradicts anything that science has to say at the moment is wrong, which is complete BS, right? I couldn't watch his Cosmos series. I know there's a lot of BS coming from him. I know there's a lot of lies coming from him. I know his huge ego, right? I've heard, like, the whole concept of science is this. Science is supposed to change with time as we acquire more information. The first person that said the reason that people die after surgery, there's a huge mortality rate after surgery, you know, 100 years ago or whatever years ago, right? And the first person that said the reason for that was because surgeons weren't washing their hands. There was something invisible on their hands called bacteria that would get into the body of the people they were doing surgery on, and they would get an infection and they would die. He was shunned by the scientific community, right? That person was ousted. They can, I don't know what happened to him, right? I used to know, I forget, right? I looked at this stuff a little bit. So he was shunned away, right? That was the establishment. Tyson is the establishment. He's a gatekeeper. I don't like him. I won't bother listening to him. Index, can you give us some useful examples of using statistics-based economic information to filter out meaningless opinion-based news? Oof. I don't run any algorithms, but what I do is just, I think it's just experience from my part. Maybe I've just been involved in politics a long time. Give us some useful examples. Let me think about that for a little while, Index. Let me read that again. Can you give us some useful examples of using statistic-based economic information to filter out meaningless opinion-based news? Here's one example, okay, that'll give you. And both, all political spectrums use this when it comes to news, right? Whatever topic they're talking about, right? I've heard this on Democracy Now. I've heard this on Real News. I've heard this on MSNBC and CNN. I've heard this on BBC, Al Jazeera. I've heard this everywhere, right? And as soon as I hear this, I go, dude, get away from you people, right? Here's what they say. They give you a number. They say, this many people were affected by something. This many people died. This many people think this way. This many people I'm migrating. This many people, or this many of something. And then they give you some completely irrelevant bit of statistics, trying to get an emotional reaction from you by linking that up and saying that's more people than died because of this. That's more people that live in this country. That's more people that live in this city. That's more people than, 50 years ago, right? As soon as I hear statistics like that coming from corporate media, I just automatically make a little note myself not to trust these people, okay? One of the things they do is they say, oh, there are 100,000 people right now that are in poverty in this, don't know, wherever it is, right? That's more people than there was in the 1980s, right? But that doesn't make sense because statistically, you have to find out if that's statistically relevant. It's not just if it's more people. The question is, what percent change has there occurred, right? If this 100,000 people are 1% of the population, and back then 50,000 people were 2% of the population, that was more significant than 100,000 people. Do you follow how I'm saying? I can't go any deeper than that in having specific examples. It's so broad. It's so broad. My apologies, Index, if I'm not being more precise with this. Wilson, how are you doing, guys? It's been too long. I'm sorry I haven't been around lately. I hope you're all doing well. Doing very well, Wilson. Thank you for popping by. Thank you for popping by. No worries, man. We'll be around a long time, right? Yeah, that drives me crazy as well. That's more people than the population of Guinea. Miles, I don't think he has lied about things in science. He has. I've caught him. Okay. He's dismissed opinions, theories, because he has, this is, we're talking about Tyson again. He has dismissed theories because he doesn't know, or he doesn't have the data to confirm the theories or not, right? But a theory is a theory. You need to investigate that theory. You cannot just dismiss a theory, right? That is his flaw. He assumes he knows everything right now, right? Even the simplest scientific facts should be allowed to be challenged, okay? 100%, 100%. But something doesn't become scientifically sound until it's been studied greatly using the scientific method and peer reviewed, and then you have to have other people get the same results. Only then it is scientifically sound. 100% agree with you, Miles. 100% agree with you. Science is investigated, and the main thing with science is you need repetition. You need to be able to conduct an experiment and get the same results, right? Here's the problem. The first problem is scientific method peer reviewed. The peer review process in the Western world is horrendous, right? There are gatekeepers that dismiss blank out everything. The second problem is, and this is fact, like scientists, professors, people who peer reviewed scientific papers, people who have worked for scientific journals have come out and said that there's huge censorship happening because certain dialogue, certain discourse is not allowed, right? And keep this in mind, that the general population doesn't have access to that scientific information. You have to pay to get it. You have to be part of an institution to be able to review all these papers. If all of these papers, these experiments, are being done with taxpayer money, they should be in the Creative Commons, and we should have access to all of it, right? That's one thing Aaron Schwartz got burnt for, right? He downloaded a whole bunch of scientific papers and made available to the whole, to humanity, right? So the science establishment, those in power right now, control information. We can't base everything on what they say is fact or not. The other problem is a lot of governments have forbidden experimentation, scientific research, into a tremendous amount of knowledge on this planet, right? You could go to jail being a scientist. You could go to jail doing scientific research on certain topics, right? That is not how science works. Politics should not have a say in what scientific experiments could be conducted, okay? That's the reason why Tyson is a gatekeeper, because he refuses to acknowledge that, one of the reasons. And he dismisses theories that, as of right now, scientists cannot conduct experiments on those theories, because it's illegal to conduct experiments on those theories, because you get sent to jail. So how could you dismiss those theories, right? The doghouse, evolution is fake as hell. Evolution, it's funny. I would call it adaptation. Evolution is, a couple of people, evolution fake as hell. Evolution, the way people perceive evolution to be, most people, the way it's taught, there's serious flaws in it, in my opinion, okay? But evolution, adaptation, everything evolves. It's evolution. The word evolution is not fake. Evolution is a fact, right? Where that information for evolution is applied can be questioned, but evolution is a fact, okay? What's your opinion about cloned organ transplants? I'm okay with it, as long as it's we do contained experiments. One of the problems with science right now, because it's corporations controlling science, right? Corporations and governments, they're doing experiments without the experiments being closed, right? When you're conducting an experiment, you have to make sure the experiment is contained, where whatever you're doing is not gonna filter out into the general public and cause a catastrophic event to occur, right? One of the best examples is GMOs, right? Terminator C's and all this jazz, right? We believe, like, as a collective, right, governments, societies, we believe some of the most brutal corporations in the world, where they've done experiments and they're releasing a certain product and they're telling us it's safe. We have to be idiots to take their word for it, right? So I'm okay with science increasing longevity, increasing our health, getting us to live in harmony with the environment and seeing us into the future. But science has to be, experiments have to be contained. We can't go out there and do an experiment. We have examples where people have transplanted, this species from here over here, and they just destroy everything, right? We have to be careful. Review is pretty fucked up. A lot needs to change. They also tend to do things like peer review with one or two people in the same lab and call it wide consensus. Agreed. Yeah. NASA recently said all NASA studies will be published for free viewing on, oh, it's locked up, NASA website. Okay. Yeah, no, we're not allowing any links to anything on the chat because people, we're getting trolls coming in providing links to phishing websites and stuff like this. I hope so. But we also have to keep in mind the origin of NASA. Where did NASA begin? I don't believe everything that NASA says. I like the concept of NASA. I check out their website. I look into the data coming from NASA because I did geophysics. I like astronomy. I love astronomy. I love the cosmos, right? I've read a fair bit. I've written a little bit. Listen to, I like sci-fi, right? So love information coming out of NASA, but I don't think all information is coming out of NASA. I think they're controlling certain bits of information. Index, I can only speak about peer review in the humanities, but it's pretty screwed up as well. Things get published based on research trends rather than quality work. Yeah, in science works the same way. In science works the same way. Talk about NASA. Do you believe in the moon landing? The first one, maybe not, but there was a few one. There was a handful of ones, I believe. They went to the moon more than 10 times or something. I looked into stuff a long time ago. As far as do I believe in the moon landing? One thing I'll mention. Look, there's lots of theories about us, humanity, politics, economics, where we are, where we're going, where we've come from, and what type of technology information is hidden from us, right? If you start going down the rabbit holes, all these theories, right, of what has occurred, what hasn't occurred, you're going to get lost, right? The most important thing to know about all of these theories, all of these thought processes, Dante, how's it going? Don't know, see, long time, no see, definitely. All of these thought processes, information that we know about the world, life, governments, economics, and all this jazz. All we really have to know is we don't know. We don't know what the truth is. All we have to agree on, we cannot believe everything that comes out of centralized governments, centralized corporations, centralized states. They're telling us lies. There's a lot of disinformation there. So as long as we're aware that we don't know what certain facts are or what certain lies are or any of that jazz, then we can all of a sudden make decisions for ourselves without being played with, without being a tool, as previously came up, where social media gets us appalled about something, right? All we have to know is NASA lies, governments lie, corporations lie. How much of what they're saying, is it truth or is it a lie, right? That's up to you. And which parts is it true and lie, right? They might be telling big lies, but all the little things are true. So you can believe the little things and forget about their big things, their conclusions. Moon landing, unless I go to the moon and see the American flag planted there, I question it, right? Right? Has there been a moon landing? Probably. Why hasn't there been one again? I don't know. Good question, right? Good question. Has there been one again? Possibly, possibly. Do I know? I don't know. Do I care? Not really. There's a lot more. lot of other things that I'm focusing on right now than the moon landing. All I know is anybody that believes in the lone gunman is a fool, right? And as soon as you realize that what we know about JFK, what we know about Oklahoma, what we know about, we think we know about World War II, World War I, what we know about history, if we believe what has been told to us by centralized governments, then we're fools. We have to question it all. The BBC isn't allowed to say anything controversial because it's paid for by taxpayers. Yeah, BBC is just like CNN, as far as I'm concerned. There's so much BS coming out of the BBC. Like, really, it's amazing. It's to a certain degree, it's better than CNN. And most American mainstream corporate news, but BBC is horrendous, horrendous. Their lies are more intricate, right? Like CNN and American corporate media is more like Donald Trump speaking, and BBC is more like Obama speaking. They're both telling us lies, but one is better spoken. Bob Miles. Andrew Wakefield made a very flawed study that said vaccines cause autism, and it was only done with a few subjects. The problem with vaccines is there's a lot of history with vaccines that we know the corporations released vaccines that caused a lot of illness in the world, right? The corporations that are producing these vaccines, they're some of the most evil organizations in the world. So whatever they tell us, we have to take with a grain of salt. We can't believe them, right? And you can look into this, right? And governments have used like insane, right? Like the US government in the 19, I can't remember, 1940s, 1950s, 1960s, on the pretense of giving vaccines, they injected people with syphilis. They injected people with radioactive products, right? The US government has sprayed towns with radioactive waste just to see what would happen. So I'm sorry, I don't. Are vaccines good? Could be. Are vaccines bad? Could be. But I personally don't believe the blanket statement that vaccines are good or that vaccines are bad, right? Look at the history of the corporations releasing these vaccines, and you tell me if you will put your faith into these corporations, right? Good morning, Chicho. Good morning, Zare. How are you doing? Good morning, good morning. What's up, Chicho? Tante, long time no see. Yeah. Do you think about vegetarianism? Do I think about vegetarianism, or do I think about vegetarians? I know people who are vegetarian, right? I have family members who are vegan. I have very close friends that are vegetarian or vegan. It's a dietary preference. Anybody that wants to eat in a certain way, they have the right to eat in a certain way. So I don't think about vegetarianism. There's times in my life where I just eat vegetables and fruits and stuff, for a week or two, and then I eat meat. There are times where I eat meat, right? I change my diet. No incentive. Da-da-da-da. I never see any BS from them, really. From BBC? I'm assuming that's BBC. Yeah, BBC. I've caught them lying a lot. Just the BS. Like, what was their thing with Iraq War? What was their thing with Syria? What was their thing with Libya? Right? Did they push the government's mantra of going to war? As far as I know, before the 2003 Iraq invasion, from what I recall, BBC didn't question it, right? Just consider this. And this isn't the BBC. I know more about the US and Canadian forms, corporate news. But Phil Donahue basically gave birth to day talk daytime television talk shows, right? He was huge. He was online for like 30 years, right? Before Oprah, they became Oprah, Donahue was huge. Oprah was a nobody, right? But in 2003, before the Iraq invasion, Donahue came out publicly and questioned the invasion of Iraq, right? And he was online for 30, 35 years, right? Huge. The guy's an icon, right? They took him off air, right? That's crazy. That's control, right? What chat are you reading? I'm reading the Twitch chat, the stuff that's popping up right now over here, I guess. This over here. Why do we need analysis to tell us what to think? I'm tired of reading opinion pieces. Fact-based news should be enough. I recognize fact can be presented with its own bias, but it doesn't have to be have the same impact. I agree with you. And by the way, here, Spamalot, I'll give you another example where BBC lies or doesn't tell the truth, right? Bill Hicks, let me see if I can find his quote exactly. Because I've used it in my articles. Okay, let me read you this. Okay, and ask yourself, has the BBC ever written anything? Ask yourself, Spamalot, if BBC or any corporate news source in the Western world, if this quote from Bill Hicks applies, right? And I'll read the first paragraph, the paragraph that I wrote into this, right? And this is taking a Bill Hicks break here. Let me give you the link to this piece that I wrote. And this is me. Oh wow. Okay, there's a few comments coming up. So I'm just gonna read this and I'm gonna read the comments later. So this was a post that I wrote, taking a Bill Hicks break, what it means to be free. And I'll read the first two paragraphs on this, and then I'll read Bill Hicks's quote, right? Every now and then I take a Bill Hicks break to remind myself what it means to be free. It's that time again. Just to give you an introduction, one of my personal enlightening moments from Hicks came when I first heard him ask why there was never any positive drug stories on the news. If the news were truly impartial, then there would have to be positive stories, but there never is. This took me weeks to really digest. And here's quoting Bill Hicks, and this is from 1989. Okay. Quote, "You know what's wild? You never see a positive drug story on the news, do you? You never see one. Isn't that wild? Isn't that weird? Don't you think that's strange? I mean, the news is supposed to be objective. Isn't it supposed to be the news? But every drug story is negative. Well, hold on. Hold it. I've had some killer times on drugs. I'm not promoting it, but I'm not denying it. Let's hear the whole fucking truth." That's Bill Hicks' quote. Now, if you can tell me that BBC has done just as many or even a fraction of positive drug stories as they've done negative drug stories, then I'll rethink about the BBC. Okay. Neoclassical or Keynesian economics? Oh man. Starsky. Flood the economy with money or don't flood the economy with money. Both of those have serious problems, in my opinion. Both of them have some benefits. You know what? I don't want to say neoclassical or Keynesian, either way. Are you good at math? I don't consider myself to be a mathematician. I just know enough mathematics to be able to use it as a tool in my life, okay, and teach it to others, high school math specifically. Vegetarianism means not kill animals if people can live without it. I don't think vegetarianism means that. But we can give it that definition if you like. So what do I think about not killing animals? Sure, if you don't want to kill animals, don't kill animals. But animals cannot kill animals, and human beings, we are animals. So if other animals can kill other animals to survive, then why should human beings be restricted from killing other? Do you follow what I'm saying? I don't want to look at, just take one side or the other. I think people have the right to decide not to do any harm, not to take a life, right? Not to kill other things. But that's not necessarily what happens in nature. Nature is brutal, right? So I think it's a personal choice. Your question then is, what do you think about meat eaters, not vegetarians, meat eaters? Possibly, if that's your question. Miles, as for the American cable news network, CNN is probably the least biased, but Fox News, MSNBC are pretty heavily opinionated and are more like talk radio hosts than news anchors. If you want to think about it that way, but CNN is garbage, like pure garbage. UK is the best country in the world. Are you guys gonna get the World Cup? Is the cup coming home? Is the cup coming home? That's the question. That's the question. Zare, do you think it's inevitable that as long as journalism is done for profit, then it will be skewed towards certain biases and certain untruth? I think it's inevitable that people who call themselves journalists, that there will be people who call themselves journalists that have biases and been paid for. But I don't think journalism, for-profit journalism, is a problem. I think journalists have the right to make money, to make a living being a journalist. And I think personally, I think they should have a right to make a phenomenal living being journalists, right? And if they're presenting an unbiased view, and everybody's biased, but if they're trying to present both sides as a story, then I have no problem with that, as long, if they have an opinion. If they pick one side, that's fine. That's their choice to pick one side, right? But as long as they're not dismissing the other side, as long as they agree that the other side also has a perspective, right? Like Phil Donahue made a fantastic living doing his talk show, right? And as soon as he came out and it was against the Iraq War, they took him off air. Why is that? They didn't take all the journalists that were pro-war off the air because they were pro-war. Then why would they take Phil Donahue off air, right? Phil Donahue deserves tremendous financial gains, as far as I'm concerned, right? Max Blumenthal deserves tremendous financial gains, right? There's a lot of journalists that I have tremendous respect for and have donated money to them, right? And I've supported their work because I believe they should be paid. Economics cannot be separated from any other aspect of our lives. It can't be. My two cents. Held a message for reasons. Question, man. Does it taste good? Yeah. Let's ban the guy. Let's see if we can. No. We can't. P. Wilson at block term. Cool. Thanks, Wilson. Zara, I think you're right. I guess the question is, what seven? Whoops. I guess the question is, which news source has the least skin in the game? I don't know. Which news source, either politically or financially, Spamalot. Well, it's been all over the BBC recently. with a boy with epilepsy and his need for cannabis oil, but never seen anything negative really. Well, just ask yourself this, we're in 2018 right now. Where was that news 18 years ago? Where was that news 10 years ago? Where was that news 20, 30 years ago, right? Just imagine how many millions of people could have been helped if BBC was doing their job, right? And BBC, man, Jimmy, what was that guy's name that had a show on BBC that he molested children up the yin yang for number of decades, and BBC hid that information? BBC is evil. BBC is corrupt. Jimmy Savile or whatever his name was, holy cow, man, the guy molested more kids than the what was it, the gymnastics trainer for the US Olympic team, right? So, you know, you have to put all that into context. Some of the executives of BBC are evil, 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 right? How could they hide that? They're at the same level as the Catholic Church, right? Ditch liberal economics and embrace Marxism. Where are you from? Where you live? Canada, West Coast, loving it. If humans are animals and animals can kill other animals, humans can kill other humans. Animals don't kill other animals, okay, for pleasure, right? They do it out of necessity, okay? There's a big difference between murder and kill. I think, my personal opinion, you have the right to defend yourself if someone's trying to take your life, but you have no right to take someone else's life, right? Without cause. If they want by this, if they want by this, like, my money is on France to win the World Cup. France and England are looking great. Yesterday's game, Russia and Croatia, man, so much heart in that game. So much heart in that game. It was fantastic. It was as good as the Iran-Portugal game, right? So much heart in that game. I see it as... I see it as responsibility. An animal can't be held responsible, so it can't really have rights, since it can't uphold laws or be held accountable for. But humans can be accountable. And anger, so they have rights. Though I say it is responsibility to kill animals respectfully and humanely. I agree with you. And you can't go around just killing animals. Like, you can get charged for that. You can be thrown in jail for that, right? There's got to be some rhyme and reason behind it. What do you think about NPR? NPR is controlled. There's people that have been banned from NPR, right? Like, Nader cannot appear on NPR anymore, right? Not that I agree with everything Nader has to say, but why can't Nader be interviewed on NPR? From what I understand anyway, right? NPR is still corporate, centralized, controlled news, right? So it's better than CNN? Is it better than BBC? Possibly. The BBC local outlets do pothouse busted in local area stores all the time. They do negative drug stories on the daily. Yeah. Free Tommy Robertson. Free Tommy Robertson. Yeah. Free Tommy Robertson. Agreed on that. If the Tommy Robertson is the person I'm thinking about, yeah, free Tommy Robertson. Have to check that out. Free anybody that's been put in jail because of thought crime, insanity. 99% of species don't regularly kill their own species anyway. Oh my God, there's another ASMR YouTuber. I watched that. We're from the west coast of Canada. Nice. Yeah, that game was intense. Noam Chomsky doesn't get invited to NPR either, I don't think. He may have been banned, yeah. I don't think Chris Hedges gets on there either. Like, many people don't. Corporate news in the Western world is controlled period, right? Like period. No, because the term livestock is a linguistic attempt to de-animalize animals and justify their inhumane treatment. I agree. I don't know about that for sure, but I know a lot of terms are used to dehumanize many things, including people, right? Just before a Western country goes to war with another country, they use words that dehumanizes that country, right? It's just definition. Like during the Obama era, right, they reclassified enemy combatants as anyone over the age of 12 or 14, right? Before that, they had to be adults. During the Obama era, because they were killing children, they redefined the word to mean anybody that's 12 or 14 years or older. What? Right? It was Obama who sent a drone and killed a 14-year-old American citizen and his cousins, all kids in Yemen, in a coffee shop, right? And they call them enemy combatants. Linguistics. I would love to study linguistics at some point. Thoughts on pushes for diversity in media versus creative freedoms with regards to casting and writing. A discussion I had with a friend with regards to new Marvel comics. I have issues with putting people in positions of artistic creativity based on their race or lifestyles or genetics. To me, that's insane, right? That's reverse racism in large, and it's not even reverse racism, that's racism, right? But racism used for a good purpose, is that what they call it? I don't agree with that. I disagree with it. I disagree with it in a big way, in a big way. Spam a lot. Even though I did commit a crime, you aren't allowed to film court proceedings. That's why you see those drawings of court. Yeah, I realize that in the UK, you're not allowed to film court proceedings because I believe people are innocent before this, that, that. The guy made mistakes. The guy acted like an idiot going up there and doing the filming. I don't know exactly because I haven't looked into the laws, what he committed, what he did, and he was on bail or something, right? He wasn't allowed to do anything more political. He was already in trouble and they put him in jail. But you can't, it's called a Streisand effect. When centralized governments try to control dialogue in that form, it's gonna blow up, right? Everybody handled it wrong. People should not be spending time in jail for thought crimes. Now, Robertson or whatever his name is, he did something wrong, sure. Should he be put in jail? I don't think so. I don't think so. Not in my opinion, anyway. Or that guy who, they're trying to put that guy in jail who taught the dog to do a salute. What? That is insane. That is insane to me. Right? That is insane. In past years, I think world's faces became really ugly again. Nationalism everywhere. Turkey has dictator. None goes against Putin. In Europe, also many nationalistic waves. Arabic world will never was free. Africa, let's not mention that. If you want to know Africa, here, I'll send you a link to Africa. Africa. Here's my take on Africa. I put this main post out in 2013, but I started putting this stuff together back in 2010 or something. Okay. On a previous site, here's my take on Africa. You're going to have to justify your claims. Why nationalism wrong? Found out I was wrong when I thought I was right. Agreed, man. As an illustrator, I hate to see anything but quality put first. I agreed with you, Dandad, and angered. Like, it blows my mind that people think it's okay to to. It's insane. Anyway, we'll leave that alone. Quality put first. Nationalism is stupid. Well, nationalism is one thing, but far right movements are bad. I don't know. Go anywhere with this stuff. All we have to do, a friend of mine just had a conversation with a friend of mine a couple of weeks ago, and we were talking about the astronauts that have gone to space and come back to Earth. And I think it was a documentary or something like this, and they mentioned there was one commonality between all the astronauts that have gone into space and looked down on the Earth, right? And their basically perspective was this: when you look at the Earth, the atmosphere surrounding the Earth is like this thick, right? It's minuscule, right? It's like the skin of an apple, right? And the astronauts, basically, I'm paraphrasing and whatnot, and just sharing the information that we had during our discussion. The astronauts would all say that once you go out into space and look at the Earth and realize how thin the atmosphere is, and you realize that there is no lines separating lands into countries and stuff like this, and you can't tell, the color of the skin of the people that live on this planet, right? Then you realize we're all human beings, right? We're all, as Carl Sagan would say, on a spaceship, blue dot going through the cosmos, right? We're all the same. We're all the same. It doesn't make a difference. Color of skin, religion, this, that, boop, 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 right? We're all the same. The only division that we see, that we focus on, is divisions brought about by corporate media, politicians, those in power who have something to gain, right? Don't be a tool and pick a side based on differences, right? One of the things, I'll read a couple of comments, but remind me to mention something about Gulliver's Travels. Okay, this is a question I would always ask. I've been asking this question of people for like 25 years. Okay, I'm just going to read a couple more comments. What do you think about white Zimbabwean farmers? I think they're screwed. Same with South African ones. I think things are not going to look good for them. Personally, if I was living in a place where there's a huge turmoil coming, there was a flood coming, right? That there's no way you could protect yourself and family from what was coming, I would pack up and go, right? Family, life and health before anything, really. I am a Canadian living in a red state, and since the tariffs, I've seen a lot of hostility from people. I feel you, Index. I feel you. I'm a brown Canadian that have traveled across all of Canada, and I've been many states, and I've felt a lot of hostility from in both Canada and the United States, right? The herd mentality, the point the finger blame game, is crazy. As soon as people start doing that, you know all they're exposed to is corporate mainstream news. Feel sorry for them. Feel sorry for them. I do anyway. Really, I used to get a little angry. I don't anymore. I just feel pity for them. So that's the way I feel about it. And in index, I don't think it's going to get better, by the way. So unless you're really anchored in where you are, and I'll say this straight out, depending on where you are, your appearance matters, right? So if at some point, at any point, if you feel threatened, your well-being threatened, I don't care where you are, in whichever country you're in, really think about what's important to you. If you really want to stay where you are and deal with that threat, or if you want to pack up and go, because again, you might not be able to stop the herds, the wave coming in. With any news source, you have to think critically about what it's saying. Yeah, I agree with you. Greetings and salutations from North Korea. Modesty is vastly overrated, Richie. North Korea. Hello, how are you doing, North Korea? How in the world did you get on Twitch? Are you allowed to, is it open to go on Twitch? You must be using a proxy or a VPN or something, maybe. Exut, exut. North Korea, yeoboseyo. I believe that means hello. Okay. And I hope you guys have the same type of food as South Korea. Bulgogi, japchae, kimchi. I love Korean food. Love Korean food. What do you think of Hong Kong and China? What do I think about Hong Kong and China? In what way, Spamalot? Yeah, unfortunately, you're right. I have 3 more years of my PhD and then I'm heading home. But you're right. Health first, always. Do I like Trump? Do I like a talking head? Why would I don't understand. Why, I don't know Trump personally. Trump is the orange guy. Too funny, too funny, too funny. China's slow takeover, stealing democracy from Hong Kong. First of all, democracy is not democracy. Did Trump end up winning that election thing? That doesn't spam a lot. Before we deal with China and Hong Kong, just regarding Trump, right? The United States has approximately 330 million people, right? Approximately 330 million people, right? Yeah, right. 10 times more than Canada, right? And hello, New Jersey. And you're telling me that the two people that out of 330 million that the United States citizens have to choose from to put as the CEO of the corporation known as the United States of America was either Hillary or Trump? Are you kidding me? Right? That right there should tell you that Hillary and Trump are completely irrelevant, right? They will do, and we put out a video with this regarding the elections. I was asked what my, I kept on being asked, you know, what my opinion was regarding the election. So finally, I put out a video, and I don't have the link right now. You know, if you do Chicho elections, it should come up. Here, I'll do it. Boop. Chicho elections. Chicho elections. Chicho elections. Yeah, if you do Chicho elections, I called it some thoughts regarding the elections, right? Here, I'll click on it and pause the video, make sure it's not running, and give you the link just in case. Okay, here's the link. Okay, take a look at that video. In that video, I mentioned that both Hillary and Trump, their handlers will tell them what to do, and Trump is a talking head. His handlers are telling him what to do. Trump is a nobody. Did Trump end up winning the election? Greatest win. New Jersey. Okay. China and Hong Kong. First of all, Spamalot, democracy. What democracy? I don't know the democratic system in Hong Kong personally. If it's, I believe it's a UK parliamentary-based system because UK had control of it. But people think that we have democracy in the United States. There is no democracy in the United States. People think that there's democracy in Canada, more so in the United States, but not. It's not democratic, right? Corporations control many things. So my opinion about China, China's slow takeover, stealing democracy from Hong Kong, I don't know the Hong Kong democratic process, but that was the deal they cut with the UK with the handover, right? A lot of people feared in 1999, I believe it was handed over, that, you know, as soon as it was handed over, China would go in and rechange everything. Kudos to them, they didn't. Right, they slowly, you know, absorbed Hong Kong and took some of the things that were going on with Hong Kong and took some of that and incorporated it within the Chinese system. Right, that's the reason we're seeing the rise of China in such a huge way in the last 3 decades. Right, they started that transition, I believe, towards the end of the 1980s. Right, building up to the takeover of Hong Kong. And now they're a powerhouse. So what people do in other parts of the world, I don't, you know, it's their business in large part, right? If you live in China, if you live in Hong Kong, it affects you a lot. I realize that, and I hope it works out. But as far as I'm concerned, living in Canada, my main concern is democracy within Canada, not democracy within China or Hong Kong, right? Because I know in Canada we've lost a lot of the rights and that we had as human beings, right? Both economically and politically. So my main concern is about that. I wouldn't, that said, I wouldn't want to live in China because there's less, well, there's more freedoms regarding certain things, but there's less freedoms regarding other things. For me, the internet is huge. So I need an open internet, so hence here, right? But well, hence here because I love Western Canada, I'm Canadian, right? But you know, I'll leave it there. Greeting, a lot of people aren't happy with the way the election turned out. We're feeling pretty helpless, or certain people have gained too much confidence due to Trump's behavior. Trump was put into power to shake things up because a lot of things are changing in the world. Okay, a lot of things are changing in the world. And it's not just in the United States where a lot of people aren't happy with the elections. A lot of people aren't happy with elections around the globe, both internally and externally, right? But what's happening globally right now with a lot of countries, a lot of people is, things are changing, man. Things are, we're in a period unprecedented in human history. And these changes are going to affect everyone. How it's going to roll out, we'll see where it goes. Chicho, I'm curious what your political history was like before reaching your current mindset. I've always been surrounded with politics. Even back in the 80s when I was in high school, I would get into political discussions with people, right? The first anti-war peace rally I ever went to was five of us in the 1990s, early 1990s, demonstrating against the first Gulf War. And there was five of us, right? You know, saying don't go to war. The whole world was for the war. I was against the war. Five of us were against the war, right? Because we knew who was doing it, what was going to happen, where it was going to lead to, just knowing history. It was amazing to me where we were out on campus. It was during my university days. We were out on campus and saying, don't go to war. And people sound, people dressed like hippies, people who wouldn't hurt a fly. They were pro-war. They were like, "You guys are crazy. We have to go to war." We're like, "You guys are nuts." Right? So I've been involved in politics a long time. Okay, I'm missing some. Cliff jumping, Chicho. Also, any cliff jumping plans? Oh, I plan on going cliff jumping this summer if I can get my ass to Vancouver. Just a heads up, I'll let you guys know this. The math video I had planned on doing for the cliff jumping, the mathematics of cliff jumping, that's going to be delayed, unfortunately. Beyond my control right now regarding that ASMR math video. My apologies. My apologies. Unforeseen things happened. As a Canadian, do you like the royal family? No, I don't like any royalty, any royal family. I'm in the same mindset as I believe the guy who came up with the DNA structure. What was his name? Oh man, I forget the name. The scientists and many other people, right? If the royal family, the queen came up to me and said they want to knight me, I would tell them take a hike, right? I don't want to be knighted. I don't believe in royalty. There's a lot of blood on the hands of the families of royalty. They have acquired a lot of wealth by killing millions of people around the globe, right? No one's held accountable. Someone should be held accountable. I don't like the royalty. We're all the same. We're all equal. Most Canadians don't care about the royal family. I can't speak for Chicho, but I don't care less. Yeah, neither do I. As a Brit, I don't care for royals. Good props. But my aunt is from Canada and she bloody loves them. Yeah, a lot of the older generation love the royal family. Baby boomers, once that filters out, the royal family is not going to be as like the corporate media pushes royal family up the yin yang. I don't know anyone who cares about the royal family, my age or lower, right? The only people that know that I know that care about the royal family is some senior citizens that are in their 70s, right? Most people couldn't give a rat's ass about them. Does Canada and US have a free health service, Chicho? US doesn't. Canada used to have a better health service, healthcare plan. It's been filtered out and corporations are taking over, slowly becoming privatized. Basically, United States is slowly absorbing Canada into their system, right? And Canadian politicians are allowing this to happen. So, like 30 years ago, it was basically unheard of to have secondary health care. 20 years ago, basically, it was unheard of to have secondary health care. Right now in Canada, the conversation is, what's your secondary health care provider? Insane, right? But it's not bad. If you walk into the emergency room, they will take care of you. It may take some time, and hopefully it's not hugely critical because there have been people that have died in the emergency room. They haven't care hasn't been given them, but slowly that's deteriorating if things don't change. Did the elections have a big impact in Canada? They had a big enough impact. They had a big enough impact. If the Conservatives had gotten through again, cannabis would not have been legalized, right? Even the Conservatives that were in power right now tried to stop it again, right? And they couldn't, right? The Conservatives in Canada are basically the right-wing extremists. Not all of them. I know some Conservatives that are friends that they're libertarian. They agree with, you know, the religious aspect of the Conservative Party is flawed and blah blah blah. But the Conservatives in Canada, Harper and those people, they're extreme right wing. They're fanatics, right? I know people closely that were fundraisers for them. Their opinion is extremely racist. Extremely racist. They're fanatics, right? Like one of the first things Harper did was buy, when they got into power, was buy 1,000 smart bombs to bomb Libya. How did that work out for the world, right? Fanatics. I think the royals should have absolute powers, Pamela. And nice. Thanks for using the sentence. I couldn't care less correctly. Nice. Watch this. That's true. I'm sure we'll learn from this. And if anything, Trump's election was a sign of America's mindset towards politics rather than something that just happened without cause. And by the way, my opinion, Trump's gonna get in a second term. Okay. British Empire too. Canada was set up for greatness. They could have had French cuisine, British culture, and musical technology. Sadly, they ended up with music, American technology, American cuisine, French culture, and British technology. Kudos to anyone who goes cliff jumping. I can't even rock climb. I love cliff jumping. Such an amazing feeling. Yeah, but it's great being rich. I don't know about that spam. I don't know about sake. I don't know that. Are ICE taking immigrants' children into concentration camps? Concentration camp has a huge implication. The word means a lot. They're not concentration camps. Okay. No matter how much the left wants them to be, they're not concentration camps. They are camps, but they're not concentration camps. Trump luckily stopped taking children away from their families and putting them in the desert. I think he realized he went too far, and even then, I think someone told him. Obama was taking children away from parents. Thoughts on Trump's influence on international relationships? Positive as far as I'm concerned. The more conflict between the fanatics, the better for me. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. If Trump successfully wins a second term, it would confirm the US wants a fascist regime. No, because Hillary was fascist too. Obama was fascist. So did that confirm that the United States wants a fascist regime? I don't think the United States citizens, the Americans, want a fascist regime. They don't want the status quo. That is why Trump got in. They don't want the status quo. They're up to here with the status quo. The status quo has destroyed their families, their lives, their infrastructure, their children's education, their health care. The status quo has destroyed them, right? That's the reason Trump got in, right? Okay. Not necessarily. I bet that a lot of Republicans are in favor of dictatorial regimes if they are conservative. I think a lot of Democrats are the same. They like dictatorial regimes as well. The ones in power, anyway, the citizens don't. We're making a distinction between the politicians and the citizens, in my opinion. A second election for Trump, he'd be like, fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on all of us. I have been hearing talk that he wouldn't give up power and just make himself president for life. He won't do that. He can't do that, right? And I can guarantee you, if they put Hillary against Trump again, Trump will win by a bigger land. Well, he didn't win with a landslide, but he will win by a landslide if Hillary puts Democrats put Hillary up again, right? As a conservative, I just want the government to leave me alone. Me too. I want government out of our lives, right? Centralized power corrupts, period. It is corrupted. All governments are corrupt. Decentralization of power is the solution that everyone is looking for, really. What's up, Chicho? Hope all is well. Love your energy. Thanks, John. Welcome to another stream. Open discussion politics stream. We had to do it. I had to get this done, right? politics was creeping into all of our lives. We've been going at this for almost 2 hours now. Wow. Don't you think that a constitutional monarchy is the best form of government? No. Monarchies, centralization of power is the worst form of government, because with centralization of power, you might have, a great leader, right, that takes care of everyone, does amazing things. They only have a certain lifespan. As soon as they're gone, everybody behind them is lining up fighting to take power, right? And you don't know who's going to take power. History has shown us this, right, with kings and queens. You had good kings, and then their children come into power and kill everybody. So centralization of power is horrendous. How exactly would Obama be fascist? I think you're throwing around terms. No, he was a corporate fascist. He did everything for Wall Street. What did Obama do? When Obama came into power, first thing he did was said, don't worry about what happened in the past. So that meant he held no one accountable for war crimes. So war crimes continued. What did Obama do? Obama waged more war in more countries than Bush and Cheney. And that's something crazy, right? Obama made took the laws away from news. He made it legal for so-called news to disseminate propaganda, disinformation. Okay. Corporate fascism is what we're talking about, and Obama was the perfect instrument for corporate fascists to obtain more control of the United States, and they did, right? Look at what happened with Wall Street, what they did with Wall Street, right? Insane, insane, right? I'm sorry if I'm not, I am throwing around words for sure, but there's certain meaning with the words that I'm saying, right? Well, look at what Obama did with Occupy Wall Street, right? Occupy Wall Street demonstrations were going on across the country in the United States, right? Across the country, in different counties, different cities, different states, everywhere, right? All of a sudden, overnight, they all got shut down, right? And then Obama came into power and said, or came on, his administration came on and said, they didn't give the word to shut all these down. If they didn't, then you're telling me that all the police forces across the United States, in every state, city, county, right, got together on social media and organized to get rid of all the Occupy Wall Street demonstrations overnight? That came from a centralized source, that order. Obama was a corporate fascist, period, right? But I want Oprah for president so I can get a free car. Oh, Oprah would be horrendous. Obama, like Trump, is just a continuation of the predecessor. Agreed. Did Obama do anything different than Monkey Boy Bush? Has anyone changed since Trump was elected? No. Monarchists. Is it true the world is running out of helium? I don't know. I don't know. I think having a stable authority figure with one of the most important jobs for the country, if not the world, and the amount of responsibility and decision making requires either a madman or a fool. None of them have a perfect track record, but we do better than, but we can do better than this. Those people are not in power. They don't read every law they sign. They don't know about everything. The people that we see in power, they're the talking heads, right? Their handlers tell them what to do and what to say. Okay, that's really should be emphasized, right? And just expanding on this, there is right now with the internet, with information, with technology, we have the power to have true democracy in every country, right? If there's a bill coming up to be voted on, every citizen should be allowed to read that bill and vote on it, right? And I don't think we should be passing any more laws. We need to be taking laws off the books, right? I think for the next 40 years, all governments in the Western world, right, any government that gets into power, their mandate should be eliminate laws, right? And I think governments should be held accountable to the mandates they present, right? A lot of governments come into power and they say they're going to do this, and they don't do any of it, right? They should be removed. Da, da, da. It takes more to be a fascist than just being a capitalist and imperialist. I agree that he was horrible, though. Yeah, to a certain degree, agreed. It takes more to be a fascist than be a capitalist and imperialist. We can look up those terms, I guess, at some point. I'll look those up again. We'll see what the exact like. To me, one of the main things of a fascist is they use military police power to control the citizens, and Obama did that, right? That's why I would categorize him as a fascist, because he used the police force, he used the military to control citizens. He's the first president, as far as I know, that executed American citizens with drones, right? He took out a 14-year-old American citizen without trial because he was the son of someone else that he took out, right? The next day, he took out the father. The next day, he took out a 14-year-old American citizen with a drone that was sitting in a cafe with other kids. If that's not a fascist, I don't know what that is, right? Sorry, Dante, I'm disagreeing with you, but that's politics. I'm not good at politics, though. I simply speaking my feelings. I don't know anything close to an answer or solution. Either though, I don't have the solutions, brother. Washanzi, I don't have solutions, but I know what's not working. And what's not working has to be removed off the table, right? And then we can figure out what can work, right? But there's certain things we know that aren't working. Are you an anarchist? Anarchism, it depends what your definition of anarchism is. I know a lot of people, you know, anarchism has been hijacked throughout history, right? So Chomsky is an anarchist, right? If you want to call it an anarchist, right? I believe in decentralization of power, and I believe we should have the right to live our lives any which way we want without the interference of government into our personal lives, period. Would you define yourself as a conspiracy theorist? I wrote an article on that here. Let me... Chicho. I wrote this back in... Let me see. Here, I'll send you this link. I wrote this... Well, I posted this on the news site in 2013, and I believe I wrote this back in 2009 or something. And the title of the article is Noam Chomsky, a conspiracy theorist of the highest magnitude, defining conspiracy theory. What are the theories behind the conspiracies? Okay, so to answer your question, am I a conspiracy theorist? Everything we're told by the mainstream media, corporate media, and the government is not true. There are things happening that we don't know, and we know that the government and corporate media lies. So to answer your question, 100% I believe that there are conspiracies happening all over the world, and those conspiracies affect our lives, right? Which conspiracy theories are fact, not are fact-based or not fact-based, or opinions or whatnot, that depends on the theory, right? Case. Look what Obama did in Libya. The country with the highest standard of living in Africa is now a shithole. Hope and change was forgotten once Obama got elected. I agree with you 100%. What they did in Libya, what the United States and Canada and Italy was involved, UK was involved, France was involved, all the leaders of those countries that bombed the living daylights out of Libya, and as Aksut would say, took the country with the highest standard of living in Africa and brought it down to the lowest. All of those low leaders should be arrested. All of the people that instigated that war, Hillary included, should be arrested, taken to the international trial tribunal, charged with war crimes, and whatever is deemed to be acceptable punishment, if they're found guilty, should be handed out, right? And there's a lot of things we've done with war criminals. There are multiple heroes of fascism. I recommend Umberto Eco's essay on this for starts. Okay, Umberto, I'm gonna highlight this. I might come back to all these later. I got so much reading to do. I think there are heroes in every movement, right? But that doesn't mean the movements are valid, right? Or the movements are just. What about laws regulating investment behavior? Are you in support of deregulated markets if it means market manipulation? I don't think markets, I don't think there's any control over the markets right now. The regulations are BS, right? It's crony capitalism right now, right? It's corporate welfareism right now, corporate socialism right now. So the regulations are there. They're not there to protect me and you. They're just there as band-aids, right? I think the markets should be opened, but not just Wall Street, not just in, I think everything should be open, right? It should be up to the individual to make personal choices. The problem with the markets is this: people have been burned, right? But instead of taking responsibility for their own actions, right? What they've done is they've cried, they've lost whatever it is they lost, they made the wrong business decisions, and they lobby governments to pass laws to protect them because of their own stupidity. There are scams, don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to be too harsh about this and say there aren't scams being committed and stuff like this, but there's scams being committed all the time, all around us, right? Now, are people who are committing scams responsible for people being foolish enough to buy into those scams? Buyer beware. Sure, if you find someone that committed a scam, you should prosecute them. Has that happened? Did that happen under Obama? No, absolutely not. Obama took all those people that committed those crimes for the 2008 theft, largest theft in human history, right? And it was obvious that was happening. I wrote articles starting in 2005, 2006 about what was coming in 2008, right? But when Obama came into power, he said, "Oh, we're not going to do anything. We're just actually going to take all those people that scammed the world and put them in power in government." That's corporate fascism, right? Blessings, Dr. P. Disobedience is the most effective vehicle to progress. I would agree with that. Right now, anyway, you'd want to live without interference of the government. What about your neighbor trying to kill you? Are you in favor of might makes right? No, of course not. I want government out of my personal life, right? I think people should be held accountable for crimes being committed, right? For murder, for theft, right? For abuse, right? That doesn't mean I agree with the government telling me what I'm allowed to consume, right? Or what I'm allowed to think. I'm okay with my neighbor thinking whatever it is they want to think. I'm not okay with my neighbor putting on speakers on their balcony, pointing towards me, blasting whatever music they're blasting, right? That's interfering with my space. But I'm okay with my neighbor listening to whatever it is they want to listen to, right? As long as they're not forcing their life, their opinion on me. Don't get that wrong, right? I don't agree in lawlessness, right? Societies, tribes, before governments, tribe had laws, communities had laws in place to make sure people weren't stepping on other people's toes and making life miserable for other people. We have to be civil about things, right? But having a big brother tell you what you can't eat, what you can't think, where you can go, is wrong, right? Chicho, do you have a link to news sites that you frequently visit, like Democracy Now? I don't go to Democracy Now as often as I did anymore, because I've caught them lying and using words that have no meaning and using statistics the way we talked about earlier today, right? I do have news sources that I frequent. I put out a couple of videos saying some of the news sources. I don't know where they are right now. I don't want to spend the time to track them down. But if you go, if you do Chicho news sources, I don't want to do it there. Let me do it here. Chicho news sources. And some of those have changed. If you do Chicho news sources, you probably find a video or two where I mention some of the places I go to. Just to let you know, I check out On Contact on RT with Chris Hedges. I check out Ron Paul Report. I check out what's the other one called? I forget what it's called. It's RT, it's political discussion. Where is it? Feeds. Anyway, they're on there. If you do Chicho news sources, you'll find them. You'll find some of them. Some of them has changed since I posted those things on there. The US doesn't recognize the International Criminal Court. No, it doesn't. Theories, not heroes. Chicho. Dante. Uniform commercial code is the only law. Corporate law is the only law. Corporate law. Should governments intervene in markets or let them be? The problem with governments interfering in the markets is they get corrupted 100%. And who says them? Like right now, Japanese government is buying most of the, it's the largest stakeholder in the Japanese stock market. The US government, with the QE and the trillions of dollars they pumped into the market, what did it do? Basically, what it did is made a bubble in the stock market and made the rich richer and made the poor poorer. So that was US government interfering in the markets. Was that a good thing? Hell no, that was bad, right? The real estate value, they've gone up because it's a bubble. The government gave money to their own people to buy real estate, right? So a house you might have been bidding on, there was bankers bidding on it that got free money from the government to bid it against you. They overbid you because they outbid you, right? Our government has done horrible things, and decades later we find out about events that they caused that result in the deaths of so many people, so severe damage to groups of people, and nobody does anything. They still have complete fair in our government as long as we go out and vote and protest, but when we do that doesn't work either. I agree with you. That's why I decided to go through the realm of mathematics, because I think what the problem is education. We've allowed centralized education to indoctrinate everyone, right? So everyone has the same mantra. Once we fix this centralized education system, I think in a couple of generations, we're going to see things roll out that are going to change everything. You should have shorted the market in 2008 in Chicho. I've played the market before, trust me. And I told people I would short the market in 2008, building up to it. Okay. Just saying. Is it just me, or is the stream cutting out from time to time? Oh, I hope not. But we've been at this for a couple hours, so it might be because of that. The stream is running fine for me. Okay, good. Smooth on this side. Okay. Oh, sorry about the stream cutting off on you, brother. Chicho Live, about government interference. What about civil rights? Having to serve certain groups of people is bad. You have to be more specific. I don't know what you mean with civil rights. We should all have the same rights. We all do have the same rights. We're human beings. We have the right to experience this life any which way we want, right? As long as we're not hurting anyone else. Before I join, how open is this discussion? Pretty open. How the message? Pretty open so far. Oh, how come? Allow. Sorry, one of the auto mods sometimes banned things. I just allowed the for some reason it killed someone's reply. Thank you for your feedback. I like Fox News. Fox News, I know that. Fox News, they're chicks. Go pretty open. Thanks for replying, Index. I don't know why it held the pawn use that permit term. I wish Fox News, oh, Fox News was about the species vote. You should refresh. Okay, teach you live. Well, civil rights, I mean, for instance, that restaurants have to serve black people. I think people should be allowed to do whatever they want with their business, right? If I open up a restaurant, I don't want to serve a certain group of people. I should have the right not to serve those group of people. And the market will decide if people are going to go there or not go there, right? Like, I hope this doesn't, you know, it's probably going to get me in hot water with a lot of people, but if it's a government doing it, then the government doesn't have the right to ban people from doing things, right? During the slavery era, there was, you know, governments had water for blacks, water for whites, like crazy, bathroom for black, crazy, right? That was institutionalized racism. Personal racism, I think that should be allowed, and the markets will decide that, right? I'd like to see how well a restaurant will do in my area if they say no black or brown people. They'll go bankrupt, right? And that's what should be allowed to happen. Okay, I think people should have the right to be racist if they want to be racist. Okay, that's my opinion. Now, if that racism becomes violent and they start hurting people, then yeah, I'll step in any day, right? So should other people step in to prevent them from hurting any people. But people should have the right to think what they want to think. Da, da, da. Who do you believe, the fake blonde with or that automatic auto mod auto allows after it checks it? No worries. Okay, cool. I thought of a lot of government interference actually prevented certain groups from doing things like gay marriage, or in the civil rights era, all of the Jim Crow. That was government laws preventing people from doing things. Women just had to vote, you know, got to vote in 1950s or 30s or something. They didn't have to vote, right? That was appalling, right? We're talking about individuals, not institutions. Institutions shouldn't, government shouldn't be allowed to discriminate, right? People, as a free human being, you should have the right to think and do what you want to do, right? The problem is that people aren't rational. Let's say a state is very racist. Are black people just fucked if they live close there? You know what? That's a loaded question, right? That's a loaded question. As what was his name? The historian, history of the United States. Oh my God, his name is, I'm forgetting his name. How long have we been streaming? Almost 2.5 hours. I forget his name, but history, Untold History of the United States. He wrote the Untold History of the United States. He basically said, no country should go to war, right? All wars are corporate wars in large part. And he basically said, the only thing that should be permitted, the only thing that should happen is insurrection. That's within a country, right? If people disagree with what's happening, they should rise up, right? So if you live in a place which is taking your rights away, then you should have the right to rise up, right? What about people in power being racist or homophobic or whatever? That sort of thing affects people. Like, and a teacher is harassing their student, then don't go to that school. Don't hire that teacher. The problem with the teacher being racist is because we live in centralized governments, right? Centralization of power, right? They have the centralized education system set up. So you have to send your child to the centralized school. And if where you live doesn't have any choices of alternate forms of education, then you're forced to send your child there, right? The problem doesn't come about because we don't have enough laws protecting everyone. The problem is we have too many laws, right? That has given too much power to centralized states, right? That's the problem. I know it's not as simple as that, but it can be brought down to that level. Howard Zinn, that's right, Howard Zinn. Thank you, God, man. Also, Chicho, I was responding to this, on my previous statement. Oh, okay, sorry about that. Some say segregation is good if it's equal. I don't know. Join the conversation on Discord. Yep. I don't recognize the right to be an asshole. That's how, not how society works. We regulate antisocial behavior, and that should include racism, sexism, etc. You know what? As an individual, I don't like assholes, right? As an individual, I've gone to fights protecting people from racism, right? Really. I've been in situations where I had to put some people in their place, but because they became violent, right? But as far as I'm concerned, as an individual, they have the right to be an asshole, right? Just like in my life, there has been times where I've been an asshole. Unless there is a true decentralization of power, the libertinism you're describing possible. Agreed. We need decentralization of power. Chicho, just don't quote. Just don't go to that school. You know, a lot of poor people don't have the means to just go to another school. The problem with schools in poor districts really is the schools themselves. The education being provided there is horrendous. It's horrendous. Right now with the internet, I've had this come to me before as well. Right now with the internet, just imagine the amount of hours children spend in school, having to deal with social issues, economic issues, political issues, being dictated to, being bullied and stuff like this. Just imagine if you took them, the amount of time that they spent, halved it, and as a parent, put out a curriculum for them to learn what they needed to learn from the internet, right? From the library. Their education would be worth 10 orders of magnitude more than what they're getting out of a centralized education system. Trust me. Okay. The main thing people have to do, think about when it comes to education, is educate yourself. Do not depend on a centralized power to educate you, because they are not educating you. They are indoctrinating you. Okay. Wars today are nothing more than excuses and supply and demand economics. Where has the honor gone? There is no honor. I don't think there ever was any honor in war, right? In tribal conflicts, maybe, right? But in war, nation wars, it's always been about resources. It kind of sucks ass if you're in the wrong community and you already experience racism and discrimination. Even worse, if the government that is meant to prevent you does nothing. Sometimes people are unable to go to different schools or jobs or restaurants without great difficulty. That was the problem with segregation. I agree with you, but what did that bring? That brought about mass disobedience after a while, right? And it has to be organic. It can't be forced. Whatever, that's why Howard Zinn said the There's only need for insurrection, not war between nations, right? Thank you. Yeah. I agree with you, Washenzi. I agree with you, much of what you're saying, but I think the core of it comes into the centralization of power. The more power, the bigger an institution gets, the bigger a government gets, the more corrupt it becomes. We've seen that happen. We've seen that happen. We've seen that happen throughout history. We're seeing it happen right now. Thank you, Chishko. You're a blessing. You're like a fire. Thanks for this, Dukoti. I'm not sure if I was tagged, but I had to refresh. Oh, I didn't do anything, Washanzi. Sometimes when the streams go a long time, things happen. And we're coming up to 2.5 hours. So I think we're going to wrap this up in about 10 minutes or so, guys. I love the conversation, by the way. This is fantastic. Hopefully you guys are appreciating it. Apologies if I'm being a little harsh, too loose with my words and my terminology. But I've laid out a lot of stuff I've done in the past. So if I'm misspeaking, my apologies. We can clarify stuff later on. And I do change my opinions. By the way, I'm watching follows and subs come on. Thank you for the follows and subs, gang. Very much appreciated. Very much appreciated. Chicho Live, you kind of dodged the question. You are saying that if people don't like the institution discriminating against them, they should just get to another place, but they don't always have the means to do so. Then fight back. Then fight back. If you don't have the means, then try to change the system you're living in. I'm not talking about violence. I'm against violence, because violence plays in the hands of centralized power. Okay, they will always have more the ability to commit more violence than you will, right? So my thing would be fight back, right? If you see something being done that's unjust, try to make it right, right? Like, just to give you an example, me personally, right, took the CEO of Impark. Impark is a Canadian and United States multinational corporation that owns parking lots around Canada, United States, and, you know, they're a money-making machine. They're on Wall Street and stuff like this. In Vancouver, right, the head of, I don't know if it was a CEO of Canada or CEO of West Coast or whatever, he was a top guy of Impark in Vancouver. Okay, I took them to court for giving me a ticket. I caused them tens of thousands of dollars worth of damage, me solo. Okay. I had a meeting with them, me by myself, with a judge, with a hearing before we went to court, with two or three top lawyers, with the CEO and their accountant, all of them sitting there across from me. And I had stuff documented, and that meeting took a whole day, and I took them to court and held them in court. If you see if you see something that's unjust, and if you can't escape from it, if you don't have the means, if you're trying to protect people, yourself, if you think it needs to change, then try to change it. Nothing wrong. You don't have to run. You could just try to change it. It might cost you dearly, right? But if you think the battle is worth it, then try to change it. As you know, Chicho, self-education lacks job market value and other product centralization. Agreed, more so in the past than now. I will talk about this, and I've talked about this before, Index, but something about self-education is this. Right now we have the means to show the world what we're capable of, right? In the past, you have to go to university to get your degrees and theses and do your thesis, get your piece of paper and show what you've done in the past, right? Right now, most people in Canada, United States anyway, have the means to go online and create content and show the world what they're capable of, right? That's one of the reasons I'm doing what I'm doing. If anybody looks at my history, I've been online for whatever, 14 years or so, creating tons of content. I've built a certain amount of value in that, right? That to me has opened up doors that even without certificates, without centralized pieces of paper telling people that I'm certified to do certain things, I've been contracted out to do certain things because of what I've done online, right? So I think that's going away. Unless you want to work for banks, unless you want to work for governments, which I have no desire to. I have no desire to work for centralized power. But agreed, Index, if you want to work for institutions that have a lot of power, centralized power, then yeah, you need the pieces of paper they give out through their centralized education system for you to prove to them that you've gone in debt far enough that if they train you, they guarantee that you're going to work for them for at least 5 to 10 years to pay off your debt, and you've been indoctrinated into their regime. Okay. Brzezinski. Oh, Brzezinski. It's easier to kill than control a million people. Very, very true. Very, very true. But right now, it's pretty easy to control tens of millions, hundreds of millions of people to a certain degree with social media. Hopefully, that's changing as we talked about earlier. I understand what you mean by organic disobedience. Breaking down that centralized government would hurt a lot of people for a long time. It's part of the game. We're hurting a lot of people right now with centralized government. We're a freight train going off a cliff with this power that centralized government has had. A lot of people slept through the changes that should have been happening throughout the decades, right? We have to bite the bullet. The change has to happen, otherwise we're done for, right? Better to do it now than to hurt later, much, much worse. As you know, just like the 2008 economics scam was pretty bad. We should have fixed it. It wasn't. More money was flooded into markets. The next financial crisis is gonna make that one look like a walk in the park, right? So is that what we want? To kick the bucket down the road? Or are we mature enough? Are we intelligent enough? Are we capable enough to deal with the problems that we have right now? Now, instead of letting future generations deal with them the way previous generations did to us, it's something we have to think about. Self-education is a great idea with the current state of our education system, but that's also not viable for a lot of people. Not yet, but it's becoming viable. I'm still in school. I see kids with alcoholic parents who can barely keep their. The problem with those is because those parents went through the centralized education system. A lot of the problems we're seeing in our centralized education system is because people have come through the centralized education system. So it's a perpetual machine. It's looping on itself, right? The falling apart, much less buy a computer or study material or find time to go to the library or have the discipline. School allows those kids to have a chance to success despite. I don't dismiss that. I don't dismiss that. There are people who are finding benefit through a centralized education system, but I think that's becoming less and less. It's reached a certain level where it's not significant anymore, right? So what you're saying is, Washanzi, that our centralized education system is a social setting for kids to escape their destructive family life. Then why are we calling it a school, right? Why don't we call it social programming, right? Why don't we call it a safe space instead of a school? Because they're not schools, they're not education centers. They're safe havens where kids can take a break from a destructive environment, right? That's the problem. There have also been recent cases of segregated schools where they can basically control who goes to decent schools and who goes to poorly funded schools based on area or income. Those are the sort of things people are rebelling against, and they're targeting the government to change things. One of the reasons that's happening is because of government, right? It's because of government. You need all these certificates, all these licensing stuff to be able to teach, right? Well, if people don't want to go through that to set up an institution to be able to teach, then how can they teach? Like for me, I don't have a teaching certificate. I refuse to go through the centralized education system, indoctrination system through the government to get my teaching certificate. First of all, it's going to cost me a lot of money. I have to stop doing everything else that I'm doing, right? To get a piece of paper to say, I can teach, right? If you looked at my math videos, I know this is a fact. I'm a phenomenal math teacher. I can teach mathematics to people who don't know how to add and subtract. I've taught mathematics to people where they've graduated and from high school with grade 12 math, physics, and chemistry. When I started working with them like three, four years before that, they couldn't add 2 plus 2, right? And I don't have a teaching certificate. I couldn't go into a centralized school system and teach right now, and I would never do it, right? That would take energy away from me dedicating my abilities to kids. I would have to deal with the centralized education system, which I don't want to deal with, right? And they're targeting the teacher. Yeah, schools being funded on property taxes is very disgusting. Agreed. Are you in favor of socialism? Doesn't require central power. Doesn't require central. We have corporate socialism right now. Socialism is a word that has a lot of meanings. We could talk about that in a future stream, maybe. I'm getting a little burnt out. My voice is starting to give a little bit. 2.5 hours. I believe communities should provide, should get together and build their own social structures. I don't believe that socialism should be on a centralized government level, right? Because that's what we have right now in Canada, United States. We have corporate socialism, corporate crony capitalism. That's the problem. One of the problems we have right now, right? It's not socialism for the individual, it's socialism for corporations, right? So personally, I think laws should be in place to prevent types of discrimination or segregation. We should make an effort to make public schools and jobs better rather than giving them up for complete anarchy in the hopes things fall together neatly. I don't think you're using the word anarchy in the full definition of anarchy. I think with anarchy, you mean chaos. Possibly, if I might be reading into that, Washanzi, because the way people power is held holds some people in the minority. If laws were lifted, the majority would just swarm and take advantage of them. That's the reason we have, there are certain laws that should be on the books. We're ruled by majority should be, prevention of rule by majority should be on the books. That's why you have, you know, one vote doesn't. Okay, heading out, Chicho. See you later, Index. Thanks for popping by. By the way, thanks for the stream. My pleasure, my pleasure. So, individual rights are very important. So, majority should never have the right to do whatever they want to an individual, right? There's a lot going on there. That's very interesting. This has been an enlightening discussion. Glad you enjoyed, brother. And you definitely are a good math teacher. Your videos are really helpful. glad you're finding them helpful, brother. Dante, we don't have socialism even remotely. We have capitalism. Property, property is privately owned. That is capitalism. There are institutions that own properties. The royal family, well, I guess they're individuals. They own property. The government owns a lot of property, right? Our government owns tremendous amount of property. Right, both in Canada and the United States. Okay, we have corporate socialism. Okay, and it is still socialism, but it's corporate socialism. So when we say socialism, we should start defining socialism. Are we talking about continue our corporate socialist institutions? I don't think so. I think corporate socialism is horrendous. Individual socialism, I think communities should provide health care. I think everyone should have access to education, access to housing, access to healthcare. Okay, those are the three musts in any society, right? Are we calling that socialism? I don't want to call it socialism. I used to call it socialism, but I don't want to call it socialism because socialism has been hijacked, right? There are people proposing socialism, running as socialists that propose some horrendous things, right? To a certain degree. That isn't rule of the majority exactly, is it? That is more like oppression by the majority. There is a difference between that. It's referred to as rule, I think as rule of the majority. I might be getting it wrong, the terminology. The vast majority of the economy is in private hands. Let's think about that. The vast majority of the economy is in private hands. Okay, let me think about that for a second. What do we consider the economy to be? Mass. If you're thinking about Wall Street, majority of stocks on Wall Street are in institutional hands, centralization. So is that private? To a certain degree, I guess. Don't you agree that the government is obliged to interfere in the lives of citizens in order for them to effectuate fundamental rights, the principle of non-discrimination in horizontal relations? Oh wow. Horizontal relations, so you're talking about one-on-one, right? One-on-one, people have the right to discriminate against each other. If someone, I've come across people that don't like me. They have the right not to like me. I don't like them, maybe. Right? The government has no right to say that I have to like them, right? That's to a certain degree. Okay. As for the but interfere, as for the beginning part, obliged to interfere in the lives of citizens in order for them to effectuate fundamental rights. The government takes away individual rights. The government is not giving rights to people, right? Under the pretense of giving rights to people, they do certain things, but they're taking rights away from people, right? That's what the purpose of government is, to govern people. As soon as you have a secondary body governing you, then you're giving away your rights. Get 10 people together, put one person in power, and say that person has the right to write the laws of how these people can communicate, right? That one person just took away the rights of everyone, right? It might have given power to one person, but if that person decides to do something else that goes against that law, their rights have been taken away. It's not owned by the state or by the public in any way. But the vast majority of economy. Okay, this is about private. Just because the capitalists came together and formed corporations doesn't make it socialism. Socialism was the means of production. Our own. Oh, okay. So we're talking about means of production. That we're getting to Marxism and stuff like this. So we're not talking about the general socialism where everyone's wishy-washy about and want to be socialists and stuff like this. We're talking about means of production and stuff like this. In large part, I got to do a little bit of research into that, Dante. Read up on it. I read up on all this a long, long, long time ago, right? Wolf, what's his name? He's very good with this, with the means of production, and I've listened to a lot of his lectures, read up a lot of on his stuff. I agree that workers should control more. They should have more skin in the game. 100%. We should have more skin in the game, right? And if we don't, then we shouldn't give out our labor for free. The problem with labor right now being given out for free is because the corporate socialist state, right, the governments that are controlled by corporations have passed laws to take power away from us, from the workers. Okay, so rights don't exist without a public body acknowledging them. No, as a free human being, I have the right to think what I want, right? I have the right to do what I want as long as I'm not hurting anyone else. My rights, right, are only rights because the government has said pass laws saying that they give me the right to do something, or they've taken the right away from me. That's what rights, the word rights comes into play, right? We're going to talk about this, by the way, rights a little bit in the next live stream when it comes to quantifying abortion. Just continuing with this discussion. Maybe I'll leave what I'm trying to say in that video on Tuesday. I think the United States government is a publicly funded extortion mafia. Agreed on that. We pay them for protection and the right to own property, and if we refuse to pay, we go to jail, or even worse. Agreed. 100%. Taxation is theft in large part. It has become. Thanks for the stream, Chicho. Need to do some work. Me too, brother. I also have homework, but I'm really the best. Yo, for real. Okay, gang. That's like, I don't know, 2 and a half hours, 2 hours, 40 minutes or something. Let's do a little up time. Let's see how long we've been up here. Up time. Boink. 2 hours and 41 minutes. So I would say that was a successful little open discussion. Yeah, see you later. Nice. So we'll call it a day, stream for now. I'll be back on, let's see if we got these things. Tuesday? Okay, July 10th. We're gonna do ASMR math. Let's quantify the abortion debate. Let's put it on a number line. Okay. Whew, I got here a bit late. Oh, Rob, how you doing? Yeah, we're just cutting it, ending it. 2 hours and 40 minutes, that's a long time. It was a nice discussion, actually. I loved it. It went better than I thought it was gonna go. Whew, I guess he's kicking us out. See you another time, Chicho. Not kicking you out, but you're the best, man. Have a good one. Oh, thanks, brother. Thank you. Oh, thank you. So we're gonna do one on abortion, and we're gonna do a comic book haul on Thursday. Okay, so if you can make it, Tuesday, July 10th, 4 p.m. We'll do a little ASMR math. I'm gonna record it as well with the lapel mic. I'm not recording this. This is just a live stream with a little lapel mic, and we'll see how it goes. Not guaranteed that we're gonna upload that. Not guaranteed it's gonna come out. Okay, I'm just gonna give it a shot. And on Thursday, we're gonna do a July 12th, 4 p.m. We're gonna do a comic book haul. Hopefully, I'll have the comic books by then. And just to let you know, most likely later on today on YouTube, I'm gonna upload an update video. Okay, just giving you guys an update of everything. I've been editing it for the last couple of days. It was a stream that we did previously. Okay, so there'll be a 20-minute update video being loaded on YouTube most likely today. Okay, aside from that, thank you everyone for coming here. Thank you for participating. Thank you for the questions. Thank you for challenging me. Thank you for giving me some things to look at, some stuff to consider. Okay, and we'll do this again. We'll do this again. Maybe once a month, most likely once every 2 months, we'll have an open discussion, and hopefully we can figure some stuff out. And hopefully we'll all learn something, me included. Definitely me included. There's a couple of things I highlighted here. Umbro's Eco's essay. I don't know what that is. I'll have to look into that. Okay. Aside from that, I hope you guys have a fantastic Sunday, man. Fantastic Sunday. Oh, that's midnight 00 in the UK, but I will be there, Chicho. Oh, the 4 p.m. Yeah, my apologies, man. I had to do those. The Tuesday one had to be after the World Cup, and on the Thursday one, I'm just giving myself a buffer just in case the comics come on Thursday. They arrive later on in the afternoon. Okay. Hey guys, did I miss? Yeah, 2.5 hours worth. Good night, Chicho. Sweet dreams, brother. Sweet dreams, Dante. Thank you for all the thoughts. What are rights? What are rights? What are rights? That's a great question. Rights, rights, rights. Are you a wizard? I haven't done magic yet. Let me rephrase that. No, I'm not officially a wizard. Okay, gang. I'll see you guys Tuesday or Thursday or future streams. Thanks for popping by. Bye for now.